Hi everyone, myself Dr. Manjunatha C, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, RB College of Engineering, Bangalore, India. In this video, I would like to discuss the first synthetic plastic that has been invented, that is Bakelite. Its preparation and properties and applications will be discussed in this video. Bakelite, it's also called phenol formaldehyde because it's prepared by two monomers, phenol and formaldehyde. This was the first synthetic thermosetting polymer which was prepared in 1907 by Leo H. Bakeland. The Bakelite word actually derived from the name of the inventor, that is Leo Bakeland. It is a thermosetting polymer actually prepared by condensation polymerization of two different monomers, phenol and as well as formaldehyde, in the presence of an acidic or alkaline catalyst. Based on the conditions, you will get two different intermediates in the preparation of Bakelite. So let us look at the two different cases of preparation. That is, the first case is when you take a phenol composition, the mole ratio of the phenol is high than that formaldehyde. Means the reaction mixture will have more amount of phenol than formaldehyde. Then it is subjected to polymerization, condensation polymerization. You will get the intermediate products like monomethylol phenol, ortho and para substituted methylol. This is ortho substituted methylol phenol, and this is a para substituted methylol phenol. Because phenol, the OH group is an electron donating group, creates the negative charge at ortho and para position. The ortho and para carbons are negatively charged. So therefore, this formaldehyde undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. This minus charge reacts with the partially positively charged carbon of carbonyl group. This formaldehyde carbon is having partially positive charge because of the electromeric effect. So because of that, we will get monomethylol phenols. Because the phenol composition is more, hence we get two different monomers, ortho and para. Again, because of the presence of more phenol in the reaction chamber, that unreacted phenol again reacts with the formed intermediates, monomethylol and orthomethylol or paramethylol phenol combined with the phenol and resulting in the formation of a three-dimensional linear, actually it is, most of it is linear structure, a polymer is formed that is called novalac. This novalac, one thing is you should observe here is each monomethylol phenol groups are linked via a methylene linkage. This is CH2 linkage, CH2, CH2, CH2 linkage is going to form between the methylol phenols. This CH2OH reacts with H of the phenol. H from this H and OH combine to form water, and CH2 is going to link to para position of the phenol. So like that, the polymerization continues, and wherever the methylol groups present at the para position, we can expect the linking at the bottom part also. It, as a result, it is going to form a side group in this linear backbone. So this is the structure of novalac, which contains only methylene linkage between the methylol phenols. This is about novalac. In another case, if you take, actually before going to the next case, let me discuss the mechanism briefly. This is a methylol phenol in acidic medium, because we take phenol more, definitely it will be acidic medium. This will form OH2 plus, and there is a breaking of this bond. This H plus comes from acidic medium and it forms OH2 plus protonium ion, water, protonated water, we can say that. And because of that positive charge, this bond breaks down heterolytically. Okay, so these two electrons shifts to oxygen and it forms water, and the CH2 forms carbocation plus. This carbocation forms a bond with, there is a negatively charged carbon here because of this electron donating group creates a negative charge at ortho and para position. The CH2 plus is going to form a bond like this. Like this, the methylene linkage is formed. Similarly, para linkage. Para is also negatively charged on this side. This is how the polymerization is taking place in acidic medium in novalac. The second intermediate polymer of bakelite we get is resol. That is another intermediate product formed when we take less concentration of phenol than formaldehyde. If the formaldehyde concentration is more, then we will have less amount of phenol. Therefore, the same phenol is going to form a bond with more number of formaldehyde groups. Therefore, you get monomethylol, dimethylol, and as well as more amount of trimethylol phenol. Ortho and para trimethylol phenols are going to form in this case. These are the first intermediates formed. These intermediates undergo polymerization, condensation polymerization. The CH2OH and CH2OH, they undergo condensation polymerization. H of one group and OH of another group, resulting in the formation of water. Therefore, CH2O, CH2 linkage is forming. Here, CH2O, CH2 linkage is going to form. So in this case, an ether linkage is forming because CH2OH, CH2OH is reacting here. But in case of novolac, CH2OH reacts with hydrogen. That's why we get methylene linkage there. But here we are getting ether linkage. That is a structural difference between novolac and resol. So because of the presence of methylal groups in all the three directions, this will form three-dimensional network, less linear. So this is how two intermediates are formed. The bakelite can be prepared based on the requirements, whether you want a linear or 3D network. You can, by optimizing the composition of phenol and formaldehyde, or you can have different types of bakelites. You can prepare novolac. When you cure it, you will get bakelite, or resol, novolac, resol. That combination you can try to get bakelite. So like in case of epoxy resin, we use amines as a curing agent. But in case of bakelite or novolac or resol, just by heating, thermal treatment, they undergo 3D cross-linking. Therefore, it is called thermosetting polymer. The properties of bakelites are, it's a thermosetting polymer. Once it is molded by applying heat, it attains a permanent shape and it cannot be changed back by any means. It has a good adhesive and bonding properties. After thermosetting, it becomes rigid, hard mass, exhibit high resistance to heat, fire, water, chemicals and solvents. And it has a high abrasion resistance, but they are slightly susceptible to attack by alkalis because this will have some amount of phenol group, acidic group. Because of the presence of acidic groups, it may react with some basic components, basic chemicals like alkalis and etc. It's very hard and infusible, and it has a very good dielectric property. Therefore, it's been used in most of electrical devices. It's been used molded articles such as radio and TV parts and pen barrels, phonograph records, and it's been used as a decorative laminates, wall coverings, electrical goods such as switches, plugs, etc. And for bonding glue for laminated wooden planks and varnishes, lacquers, and sulfonated phenol formaldehyde resins are being used as ion exchange resins. So this is the toy made up of bakelite. It's a very old toy, stove, telephone, and wooden furnitures, bangles, electrical switches. These are all because it can withstand high temperature. Handles for cookers and cooking utensils are made up of this bakelite. So with this, I'm concluding my discussion on bakelite. If you have any questions or clarifications, please email me through this using this email IDs. Thank you for watching this video.